In a previous video, we talked about identifying intercepts of a graph, finding those points where the graph crossed either the x or the y-axis. Now we're going to use intercepts to graph lines. Now, if we're talking about a slanted line, you're always going to have an x-intercept and a y-intercept. But if we have a slanted line that goes through the origin, then the x and the y intercept are actually the same point, 0, 0. If we have a vertical line, then you have only an x intercept. This would be like x equals, for example, 3, where it cuts through the x-axis at 3. If we have a horizontal line, then we will have only a y-intercept, and this might be a line, for example, like y equals 5. So different things go on. We're going to focus on each one of these during our exercises. All right, remember that an intercept is where you are touching an axis. And if you're on the x-axis, then your y-coordinate is 0. If you're on the y-axis, then your x-coordinate is 0. That means that I can find the intercepts by letting x be 0 and y be 0. So when instructions tell you to graph a line by finding the intercepts, you must let x be 0 and y be 0. So let's find those ordered pairs. I have x minus y equals 4, and I'll start with x equals 0. 0 minus y is equal to 4. Negative y is 4, divide by negative 1, and y is negative 4. That is the y-intercept. X is 0, and I have a y value. All right, now I'm going to still take x minus y equals 4, but I'm going to let y be 0. So x minus 0 equals 4, so x is 4. That point is the x-intercept. To graph it, I do it with my line graph tool, so I would select that button. 0, negative 4. Starting at the origin, you go 0 in the x direction, but you go down to negative 4. 4, 0, you go to the right 4, but you don't go up or down. Although I am not going to get a perfectly straight line, because it is very difficult to use a ruler on this screen, so I'll just hand draw my lines. They'll be the best I can do. All right, so that's it, how you graph a line by finding its intercepts. Very similar to what we've done in the past. But in the past, we had an option to pick those zeros, and now it's a requirement. All right, let's look at another one. Once again, because it says to graph a line by finding and plotting its intercepts, I have to have x is 0 and y is 0. I have negative x plus 3y is equal to 6. I'll start with x equals 0. The opposite of 0 plus 3y is equal to 6. Well, the opposite of 0 is still 0. 3y is equal to 6. Divide by 3. Y is 2. The y-intercept is 0, 2. I still have negative x plus 3y is equal to 6. This time I'll let y be 0. So I have negative x plus 3 times 0 is equal to 6. Well, 3 times 0 is 0, so I just have negative x is 6, divide by negative 1, and x is negative 6. Okay, now that we have those two points, let's plot those. We have 0, 2, which is 0 in the x direction, 2 in the y direction, so it's a y-intercept. Then we have negative 6, 0. So I go negative 6 on the x-axis and I don't go up or down. So there's my line. And it would be nice if it were a straight line, but as I've explained, it is difficult to use a straight edge on this computer screen. All right, so there's my graph using the y and the x intercepts. Let's look at some more. All right, I have 8x minus 3y is equal to negative 24. Because it says intercepts, I know that I'm going to let x be 0 and y be 0. So when x is 0, I have 8 times 0 minus 3y is equal to negative 24. 8 times 0 is 0. So I'm left with negative 3y is negative 24, divide by negative 3, and y is 8. That is the point 0, 8. Then I've got 8x minus 3y is negative 24, and this time I'm going to let y be 0. So I have 8x minus 3 times 0 is equal to negative 24. That term becomes 0. I'm left with 8x is negative 24. Divide by 8. X is negative 3. Now I plot those. The first point is 0, 8, so I don't go right or left, but I go up to 8. That's the y-intercept. Second point, I go left 3 to negative 3, but I don't go up or down. So there's my x-intercept, and whoops, that was really bad. Apologize. There's the 8, there's the negative 3, and there's the line, which MATLAB would graph for you. So you will have chosen the graph, to the line tool, plot one of your points, click, move to the other point, click, the line will be formed. All right, next one. I have y is equal to 3x. I have x is 0 and y is 0. When x is 0, I get y equals 3 times 0. That's y is equal to 0. It's the point 0, 0. Do you remember from my first page that when you get 0, 0, that's the only intercept you're going to have? So, this is useless. This is going to be 0, 0 as well. I don't even need to do that point. I need to pick another, there I go touching things. I need to pick another value. I think I'll let x be 1. So I have y equals 3x. Plug in 1. Y is equal to 3 times 1. Y is equal to 3. 1, 3 is not an intercept, but you only have one intercept. And you'll notice right here, if only one intercept exists, use it and another point to draw the line. So I have 0, 0, and then I have 1, 3, and so I will have this line with a single intercept. All right, we have one more to do, and this one is multiple choice. So I'm going to make my t-chart. I choose to do intercepts. I do intercepts lots of times, even when I'm not instructed to. I have x is 0, negative 6x plus 5y is 15. Negative 6 times 0 plus 5y is 15. That term becomes 0. 5y is 15. Divide by 5. Y is 3. 0, 3. Okay. If I have y is 0, negative 6x plus 5y is 15. That gives me negative 6 times, whoa. We have negative 6x plus 5 times. It's the y that was 0. and I almost put it in the wrong spot. That term is 0. Negative 6x is 15. Divide by negative 6. X is equal to, well, that doesn't go in evenly. It's going to be a negative. And I just need to know about where this is. And 6 goes into 15 two times with 3 left over. So this is negative 2.5. They would not be asking me to do this except that it's multiple choice. So evidently only one of these will be close to that. All right. The y-intercept is 0, 3. Okay. This one is 0, negative 3. Wrong. This one is 0, 3. Okay, maybe. 0, 3. Maybe. 0, negative 3. No. Now the x-intercept is negative 2.5. This one is positive. No. This one is negative. It must be this one. And that is at about 2.5. You will not be asked to graph something with a fractional value. They do exist, though, and if they show up, they'll be multiple choice. Okay, that's it. That's using intercepts to graph linear equations.